हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर मैथमेटिक्स क्लास। सो वेरी फर्स्ट वी विल सी द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ प्रीवियस होमवर्क। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम लेट्स स्टार्ट। इन प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैड गिवन यू टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 4F। इन 4F क्वेश्चन नंबर फर्स्ट इज सिंप्लीफाई एंड वी हैव सॉल्व ए एंड बी and you had to solve C and D and question number second and third. Okay, so let's see the solution of C and D. C and D, 4037 minus 1951 plus 3947 minus 3185. Okay, so we have to simplify it. So, I had told you in these type of question, firstly we will add then subtract. Okay, so which number will we add? We add this and this. As we can see here, there is a no sign, so we will understand here plus. This plus and this plus. Now we will add it. So 4037 plus 3947. Okay, so let's add 77, 14, 4, and then 1 carry, 31, 4, 4 and 4, 8, 9, and 437, 7984. Okay, so next 7984 minus 1951. Okay, so 4 minus 1, 3, 8 minus 5, 3, 9 minus 9, 0, and 7 minus 1, 6. Okay, so now we have to subtract 3185 from 6033. Okay, so let's start subtracting. Here we have to subtract 5 ones from 3 ones. So we can't subtract it, so we will borrow from tens. Then here will be only 2 and here 13. Okay, so 13 minus 5, 8. And here we have to subtract 8 tens from 2 tens. So it is also not possible. So we will borrow from 100. And we can see at 100 place there is a 0. So 100 will borrow from 1000. So here will be 5. And here 10, and after giving two tens here will be only 9. Okay, and here 12. So 12 minus 8, 4. Okay, and here 9 minus 1, 8, and 5 minus 3, 2. So after subtracting 6033 minus 3185, we get 2848. So our answer is 2848. Okay, so let's see next D. In D we have to do 6287 minus 1246 minus 798 minus 2261. Okay, so we can see here there is a no plus, so then we will subtract. Okay, so firstly we will subtract this number from this number. Okay, so subtract 6287 minus 1246. Okay, so 7 minus 6, 1. 8 minus 4, 4. 2 minus 2, 0. And 6 minus 1, 5. Okay, in next step we will subtract 798 from 5041. So let's start subtracting. We have to subtract 8 ones from 1 1. So here will be we will borrow, then here will be 11 and here 3. So 11 minus 8, 3, and again when we borrow here 13, here will left 9 and here 4. 13 minus 9, 4, and here 9 minus 7, 2 and 4, and here 4. Okay, so now we have to subtract 2261 from 4243. Okay, so let's start. 3 minus 1, 2, and here we have to borrow from 100, so here we left 1 and here 14. Okay, then 14 minus 6, 8, and here again we will borrow from 1000, then at 1000 plus left only 3, and at 100 plus will be 11. So 11 minus 2, 9, and here 3 minus 2, 1. So we get 1982. So the answer is 1982. Okay. Let's see next question. Question number 2. In question number 2, a man earns rupee 6590 per month and his wife earns rupee 3280 per month. If they spend rupee 7800 per month, how much do they save each month? In this question, a man earns 6590 rupee per month. Ek aadmi 6590 rupee per month earn karta hai, and his wife, उसकी वाइफ 3280 रुपी पर मंथ अर्न करती है. इफ़ दे स्पेंड रुपी 7800 पर मंथ, यदि वो दोनों साथ में मिलके 7800 रुपी पर मंथ स्पेंड करते हैं. सो नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मच डू दे सेव ईच मंथ. तो वो दोनों ईच मंथ मीन्स प्रत्येक महीने में कितनी मनी सेव करते हैं. ओके, so my dear students, let's see the solution. The earning of a man 6590 according to question, and the earning of his wife is 3280 rupee. So the total earning of the month 6590 plus 3280. Okay, after adding we get 9870 rupee. So total earning of the month is 9870 rupee. Okay, and how much money did they spend per month? So money spent per month is equal to 7800 rupee. Therefore the money they save each month, what we will do, we will subtract 7800 rupee from 9870 rupee, because 7800 rupee they spent per month and total earning of the month is 9870. So now subtract 9870 minus 7800. After subtracting we get 2070 rupee. So thus they saved rupee 2070 per month. Okay, let's see question number 3. In question number 3, the total number of books in a library is 9987, which includes textbooks and books on fiction, travel and biographies. Then how many books are there on fiction in the library? In this question, the total number of books in a library is 9987. Ek library mein total books 9987 hai, which include textbook and book on fiction, travel and biographies. Jisme ki kuch books fiction ki hai, kuch travel pe based hai, kuch biographies hai. So if यदि 1876 टेक्स्ट बुक्स हैं, 2798 बुक्स ऑन ट्रैवल, बुक ट्रैवल पे बेस्ड बुक है, एंड 875 बुक्स ऑन ग्राफी बायोग्राफीज़, सो 875 बायोग्राफीज़ हैं। देन हाउ मैनी बुक आर देयर ऑन फिक्शन इन द लाइब्रेरी, सो लाइब्रेरी में कितनी बुक फिक्शन की हैं, ओके क्योंकि हमें पता है कि लाइब्रेरी में जितने टोटल बुक हैं उनमें से कुछ बुक्स फिक्शन की हैं, कुछ ट्रैवल पे बेस्ड हैं और कुछ बायोग्राफीज़ हैं। तो ट्रैवल की बायोग्राफीज़ की का नंबर दिया हुआ है और हमें फाइंड आउट करना है कि फिक्शन की कितनी बुक हैं। ओके सो लेट्स सी द सॉल्यूशन। द टोटल नंबर ऑफ बुक्स इन अ लाइब्रेरी 9987। लाइब्रेरी में टोटल बुक्स कितनी है 9987। द नंबर ऑफ टेक्स्ट बुक, लाइब्रेरी में टेक्स्ट बुक कितनी है 1876। द नंबर ऑफ बुक्स ऑन ट्रैवल 2798। एंड द नंबर ऑफ बुक्स ऑन बायोग्राफीज इज 875। सो टोटल बुक्स कितनी हुई, टेक्स्ट बुक, ट्रैवल और बायोग्राफी को मिला के टोटल बुक्स कितनी हुई। सो टू फाइंड आउट टोटल बुक्स वी विल ऐड ऑल दीज नंबर्स। सो 1876 प्लस 2798 एंड प्लस 875। आफ्टर एडिंग दीज थ्री नंबर्स वी गेट 5549। ओके सो द नंबर ऑफ बुक्स ऑन फिक्शन, टू फाइंड आउट द नंबर ऑफ बुक्स ऑन फिक्शन वी विल सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस नंबर 5549 फ्रॉम 9987। फिक्शन की बुक का संख्या ज्ञात करने के लिए हम क्या करेंगे, जितनी भी टोटल बुक लाइब्रेरी में है 9987 में से टेक्स्ट बुक, ट्रैवल बुक और बायोग्राफीज की बुक को हम माइनस कर देंगे तो फिर हमें पता चल जाएगा कि टोटल फिक्शन की कितनी बुक है। सो वी विल सब्ट्रैक्ट 5549 फ्रॉम 9987। आफ्टर सब्ट्रैक्टिंग वी गेट 4438। ओके सो देयर आर 4438 books on fiction. Okay, so I hope you all have understood this question and now you have to write it in your notebook. Okay, so my dear students, now I am going to start our today's chapter. Today we will solve exercise 4G. Okay, that is estimating sum and differences. So let's see estimating sum and differences. To estimate a sum or difference, first round each number to its greatest place value and then add or subtract. So my dear students, firstly estimating sum and difference, it is very important to understand estimation and rounding. So estimating a number means roughly calculating or juggling the value. Rounding is a one way of estimation. When you round off a number, you found a number that tell you about how much or about how many. For example, if you buy a pen for rupee 32, then the estimated cost to the nearest 10 rupee that you tell your friend is about rupee 30. So my dear student, estimation means that nearest to 10. Suppose that you buy a pen rupee 32, but you tell your friend that you buy a pen for rupee only 30. So 30 is estimating number. So instead of saying that there were 32, you can say there are only 30. Next example, if there were 97 visitors for an exhibition, you can say there were about 100 visitors. So estimation or rounding means approximately or near about. Okay, so first we see rounding number to the nearest 10. Mean ki hum numbers ko kaise nearest 10 likhte hain ya kaise rounding off karte hain. Okay, we use a number line to round off a number to the nearest 10. For understanding it, we use a number line. You can see here this is a number line, and here 40, this is 41, 42, 43, 44, and 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50. And you can see here I have denoted 42 and here 48. Okay, so we can see here 42 is nearer to 40 than 50. And 48 nearer to 50 than 40. Okay, it can be seen that 42 is closer than 40 and 48 is closer than 50. Mean ki 42 40 ke zyada near hai, zyada pass mein hai, and 48 50 ke zyada pass mein hai. So 42 round down, 42 rounds down to the lower 10, that is 42, and 48 rounds up to the greater 10, that is 50. Means ki 42 ko hum round down karenge 40, and 48 ko rounds up, that is 50. So my dear students, rule for rounding to the nearest 10 is look at the digit in the one space. Rounding 10 karne ke liye hum kuch rule ko follow karte hain. Rule kya hai? Look at the digit in the one space. Hum sabse pehle one space pe jo digit hota hai hum unko dekhte hain. If it is a 1, 2, 3 or 4, then round off the number to the lower 10. Yadi first digit 1, 2, 3 or 4 ho, to hum usko round down karte hain. Round down to the lower 10. So we can see here in 42, first digit number is 2. So we will 42 round down to the 40. Okay, and if the digit is 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, then round off the number to the greater 10. And in 48, we can see here, in 48, the first digit is 8. So, 48 will be round up to the greater 10, that is 50. Means, ki hum 42 ko round down karenge 40, और 48 को राउंड सब करेंगे 50. ओके, सो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, लेट अस सी सम एग्जांपल. सो टेल मी, इफ वी हैव टू राउंड ऑफ नंबर 39, हमें 39 को राउंड ऑफ करना है, तो हम क्या करेंगे? ये किसके नियर में है? सो अकॉर्डिंग टू रूल, फर्स्टली वी विल सी द फर्स्ट डिजिट नंबर, दैट इज 9. So first digit number is 9, so then round off the number to the greater 10. So hum iske greater 10 mein karenge. So greater 10 kya hoga? 40. Okay, and number second, 55. We have to round off 55. So according to rule, if the first digit is 5, so we will round off the number to the greater 10. So 55 greater 10 will be 60. 55 greater 10 will be round up and 60. Okay, and number third, 23. In 23 we can see here first digit number is 3, So it will be round down. It will be round down. So it will be round off to 20. Okay. And in 3-digit number, it is also similar to 2-digit number. So number 4, 297. So 297 rounded off to 300, because 297 is nearest to 300. Okay. So let's see another example. Mr. Jan owns a bakery. He has 49 pastries on display and 33 inside. Estimate how many pastries does he have in stock. Mr. Jan own a bakery. Mr. Jan ke paas unki khud ki ek bakery hai. He has 49 pastries on display. 49 unke paas, उन्होंने 49 पेस्ट्री को डिस्प्ले पे लगा रखी है. डिस्प्ले मतलब जो हमें बाहर से दिख रहा हो. एंड 33 इनसाइड, और 33 पेस्ट्री उन्होंने अंदर स्टॉक में रखी हुई है. सो एस्टिमेट हाउ मैनी पेस्ट्री डज ही हैव इन स्टॉक. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मैनी पेस्ट्रीज डज ही हैव इन स्टॉक. उनके स्टॉक में टोटल कितनी पेस्ट्रीज हैं, बट हमें एग्जैक्टली कितनी है वो नहीं बताना है, हमें एस्टिमेट बताना है. ओके, सो व्हाट वी विल डू, फर्स्टली पेस्ट्री इन स्टॉक. सो 49 ऑन डिस्प्ले एंड 33 इनसाइड. नाउ वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट एस्टिमेटेड सम, नॉट एग्जैक्टली, वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट अप्रोक्सीमेटली. सो व्हाट विल बी राउंड ऑफ टू 49? So 49 will be round off to 50, and 33 will be round off to 30, because we can see here in 49 there is a 9 at one digit. So here it will be rounded up to the nearer 10. So 50, and in 33 there is a 3 in one digit, so 3 will be rounded down. So if 33 will be rounded down, so it will be 30. So now we will add it. So add 000 and 538. So Mr. Jan has about 80 pastries in stock. Mr. Jan has about 80 pastries in stock. So this is not exactly, this is estimated sum, means near about. Okay. So my dear students, now we will solve exercise 4G. In exercise 4G, question number first, estimate the sum or difference. Okay. So first 537 minus 292. So firstly we will round off 537. So 537 is nearer to 500. Okay. And 292 is nearer to 300. Now we will subtract it. So 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 0, 0, and 5 minus 3, 2. So, my dear student, 200 is the answer. It is estimated difference. Okay. Look at the question number 2. In question number 2, the canteen owner of a school ordered 85 carton of mango juice, 62 carton of apple juice, and 69 carton of mixed fruit juice. So estimate the total number of juice carton ordered. The canteen owner of a school ordered 85 carton of mango juice. So let's see the solution. Carton of mango juice 85. Cartons of apple juice ordered 62 and carton of mixed fruit juice 69. And now we have to find out estimate the total number of juice carton ordered. So firstly we will round off these numbers. So 85 round off to 90. 62 will be round off 60, and 69 will be round off to 70. And now we will add it. So add all three numbers 0, 0 and 0, 9, 6, 15 and 15 plus 7, 22. So estimated total number of juice carton is 220. So my dear students, I hope you all have understood how we will solve this type of question. So my dear student, it is time to your homework. So you have to solve exercise 4G. In exercise 4G, we have already solved A, and you have to solve B and C from question number 1. And we have solved 2. Now you have to solve question number 3, 4 and 5. Okay?